Hey everybody. Today we're talking about three of the most popular growing methods for aquaponics. Aquaponics is the merger of aquaculture and hydroponic agriculture, where the waste effluent from growing fish or other aquatic organisms is used as a fertilizer source to grow fruits and vegetables. There's an incredible diversity of crops that can be grown in aquaponic systems. And there are different types of aquaponic systems to suit the needs of each unique farmer. Whether it's on your countertop or at commercial scale, there's probably an aquaponic system that's right for you. If you're liking our content, subscribe to our channel. All right, let's dive in on the three most popular growing methods for aquaponics. Number one, deepwater culture. Deepwater culture, also known as floating raft beds, is one of the most commonly practiced aquaponic growing methods around the world. As the name implies, a deepwater culture bed is usually characterized by the deep reservoir of nutrient solution, usually anywhere from 6 to 24 inches deep. Vegetables grow directly on the water surface and are suspended generally by a food-grade polystyrene raft or by a suspended platform. In a deepwater culture system, plant roots are continuously submerged in the nutrient solution. Raft beds are a favorite amongst aquaponic farmers to grow leafy greens, especially at commercial scales. Number two, nutrient film technique. While non-fungible tokens might be all the rage these days, let's give some love to the original NFT, nutrient film technique. Just like deepwater culture beds, the name pretty much says it all when it comes to NFT systems. Fruits and vegetables are grown in channels or gutters, and a thin film of nutrient solution, hence the name, keeps the roots hydrated and fertilized. This film is usually just a few millimeters thick to, say, an inch, and this can run continuously or on a timer, depending on your growing conditions and the crop that you are growing. Like deepwater culture, at commercial scales, leafy greens are the primary crop grown in NFT systems, but fruiting and flowering crops are also totally suitable for many NFT systems. Because NFT channels are so lightweight, they're a favorite for vertical farming systems. Number three, media-based systems. Now here's a complicated one. Media-based systems, also just called media beds, refers to an incredibly diverse class of growing systems. What unites media-based systems is the use of a medium, or a non-soil substrate. This substrate can be made from all sorts of material, from rock and gravel, to expanded clay and perlite, to coconut husk and peat. Really, the list goes on. We'll be putting together some videos about different mediums and their unique growing properties. Sometimes just one material is used for a media bed, and oftentimes it's a mix of substrates. Now, unlike deepwater culture beds and nutrient film technique, media-based systems can be irrigated a number of ways. Some crops like watercress and taro can really thrive in a constant flood media bed, which is basically a deepwater culture bed full of rocks. Now, other crops like the basil that we grow on campus is going to be much better suited for a flood and drain system where the roots have a chance to dry down in between waterings. Root vegetables are an absolute breeze to grow in wicking beds. And vining crops like tomatoes and cucumbers really thrive in a drip irrigated media-based system like these Dutch buckets. Don't worry if that sounds like a lot. We'll have videos on each of these growing systems, plus a few that we didn't mention here. Media beds are often a favorite amongst home gardeners and small-scale aquaponic farmers because of their similarities to soil-based agriculture and because they can pretty easily be made out of readily available materials that you could get at most hardware stores or garden stores. So what's your favorite growing method for aquaponics? Let us know in the comments. Did we mention it today? Did we not cover it? We'll be certainly talking about more growing methods and going deep into each of the growing methods mentioned today, plus a few we didn't have time for. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.